I'm Alex,
and everybody at home, you should know what this instrument is. This is an ukulele. Lindsay, tell us the history of the ukulele.
I couldn't give you a history on it at all.
I got you. Here we go, you ready? It is a four-string instrument introduced to very, very early Hawaii from people over in Europe. I just looked that up. But it is iconically known as the Hawaiian instrument of choice. In the Hawaiian culture, but in the Polynesian culture in general, you will find music pretty much anywhere. What we usually do is anytime we're hanging out as a family, as friends, as any gathering, somebody's always gonna be jamming. And I'm gonna teach you guys how to survive any jam.
Okay.
When it comes to strumming a ukulele, there's a lot of different methods, so it's hard to really choose what is the right way. But when I strum a ukulele, I like to go down with my nails and up with my nail. So you're gonna go down, kind of like you're swatting at a fly, hiya. And then when you come up, you're gonna scoop an ice cream cone, but it's not an ice cream cone, it's a thumbs up, right? That's how I learned. I'm not saying that's the right way. I'm not saying it's the wrong way. That's just how I do it. All right, let's get into some chords. And the first chord is so easy. So each of these are called frets. Each section is called a fret between the lines, each of the spaces. So if I say put your pointer finger on the third fret of the fourth string, so it's gonna be right there, boom. And that's the whole chord. That is called a C major chord. And if it doesn't sound right, it's probably because the tuning isn't fully there.
Yeah.
There's always one family member at the jam who does not have a tuned uke, and it is not good. The way that we're gonna set this up is that we're gonna let it sit for four counts, and with the four counts, you can play any strumming pattern, but for now, we'll just go one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, okay? Then, you guys, does everybody feel good about that chord?
Yes.
All right, so the next chord is gonna be a G major chord. This is the hardest chord in the whole progression. Take your pointer finger, right? You're gonna put it on the second fret of the second string. Then you're going to take your middle finger and put it on the second fret of the fourth string. And then you're going to take your ring finger and you're gonna put it on the third fret of the third string.
Oh God.
So it'll look something like this. When you're playing it, it'll look like this.
Ooh-wee, this is...
It's hard, you gotta practice it a lot. You're not gonna get it perfect the first time. So then the third chord, very, very easy. Just the second fret of the first string. That's the whole chord. That is an A minor, right? And then I'm gonna jump ahead and go to the last chord because it's so easy. You keep your finger there, but you add your pointer finger on the first fret of the third string. That is an F major. And that's the whole chord progression. So here we go from the top with the C, very slow. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4. Switch chords. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4. Switch chords. A minor. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4. And then you add the little pointer finger for the F, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, and then you go back to the C. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4. Back to the G. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, uh-oh, here comes the A minor, watch out! A minor, here we go. 1, 2, 3, and then the F. Boom, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4, right? Just those strums, just one on the one. One on the one, two on the one. And G, and we're here, having a lot of fun. Then we're here, having more fun than you could have had before. Who would have thought you could add more? Oh my gosh, we're having the most fun for this F chord. F is for fun. All right, you guys wanna try playing it together again? We're gonna play at full speed. We're gonna just keep playing those chords. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. was ukulele lessons with Alex.